Hi, this is Harold Long. Welcome to the Hill-Tran United Weekly Message and Podcast. I'm glad you're making time for this week's teaching. I will have more to say at the end, but for now, let's dive right in.
Our scripture reading this morning comes from Romans 6, 1 through 6 of the Common English Bible. So what are we going to say? Should we continue sinning so grace will multiply? Absolutely not. All of us died to sin. How can we still live in it? Or don't you know that all who were baptized into Christ Jesus were baptized into his death? Therefore, we were buried together with him through baptism in his death, so that just as Christ was raised from the dead through the glory of the Father, we too can walk in newness of life. If we were united together in a death link like his, we will also be united together in a resurrection like his. This is what we know. The person that we used to be was crucified with him in order to get rid of the corpse that had been controlled by sin. That way we wouldn't be enslaved to sin anymore. May God bless your hearing, understanding, and application of Scripture.
So things haven't turned out as you hoped. Life took a turn.
A bump, a darkened sky, and at times it may have seemed there was no hope. But here's the good news. Our God is the God of fresh starts. Our God is the God of new beginnings. Our God brings new mercies, new compassions, not just once a year, not just when things are bad, but every single morning. This season has been tough. And for many of us, things will never be the same. But we are here, breathing, maybe smiling, or crying, or shouting, or laughing. But we are here, feeling, maybe fighting, or cheering, or seeking, or grieving, but we are here. Living. And we are not alone. Our God is here. Our God is with us. And our God is the God of new creations.
Well, good morning, church. And I'm glad you're all with us. If you're listening online, I'm glad you're here. If you're listening to this on demand, I encourage you to stop and go to our website and download the bulletin and lesson plan for today. It's under the tab Bulletin and Lesson Plans because we're going to refer to it a little bit today. If you're live with us, if you'll pull out your lesson plan, you'll see the guide to lead us through today's message. On the back side of that, you'll see the next six-day challenge. I encourage you to use that as part of your meditation and prayer throughout the week. You can throw that in your Bible or whatever your devotional books you read on a regular basis. And just each day, take the quote of that day or the scripture that day and answer the reflection question to yourself. Maybe share it with a partner and just unpack that question. And it'll keep this message alive throughout the week. So I encourage you to utilize that tool big time today. You'll also see a couple other inserts in there. There will be four diagrams. Some of these aren't new. I shared them a few weeks ago. We're not going to break down these things per se. I'm going to refer to them, but they're for your own study, for your own spiritual development and maturity. And you can keep these inside Romans and refer to them often because it will really help you understand our dilemma as it comes to sin. It will also help you understand what what it means for Christ to be in us and us in Christ. It's just, I can't tell you how important it is. So we'll be referring to those today. You know, we're in a message series titled Romans, I'm Not Ashamed of the Gospel. And it's we're on no particular calendar or timeline with it. You know, we hit it a little bit, then we'll bounce around and hit a few other messages and have guest speakers, etc. But we're consistent going through this message series. So if you're listening new, you can go back to our YouTube page, to our website under the sermon tab, and you can listen to all the messages in this series up till today in order, if you'd like. But it's just one of the most important books in the entire New Testament. And I can't tell you how much this impacted my life and lives of many theologians, John Wesley being one of them, Martin Luther being another one, and the list goes on, John Calvin. It was this book, this particular text inside the New Testament that was a game changer, and it was for me as well. We spent Romans 1 through 5, those five chapters, going through and unpacking the introduction to this chapter and leading us up to chapter 5, which really is all about justification, what it means to be justified. And now we're segueing into chapter 6, verses 8, and what did...
Hi again, this is Harold. Thanks for listening to our weekly message and podcast. I hope that we have shared something helpful to you wherever you are in your spiritual journey. Just so you know a little bit more about us, we are Hill-Tran United. Hill-Tran United is an alliance between Hillsboro United Methodist Church and Transformation United Methodist Church. We are kingdom churches and kingdom communities for people who aren't into church. We meet Sunday mornings at 9 a.m. at Hillsboro United Methodist Church and 11 a.m. at Transformation United Methodist Church. Both churches are located in the northeastern tip of the beautiful Ozark Mountains, located in Jefferson County, Missouri. We also meet during the week in smaller groups that we call life groups and home churches, and that's how we make it relational. We hear regularly from people from all over who are engaging in personal and group studies based on our teaching, and we would love to know if that is happening where you are at. If you want to connect with us, you can find us on Facebook, Twitter, Instagram, Vimeo, and YouTube, where you can download our app from your favorite app store. Just search for the app titled Our Church by Church Dev and enter in Hill-Tran United, and you can access all of our available audio, video teachings, plus through the app or our website, you can download our PowerPoint slides, bulletin, sermon notes, and discussion questions. It's all there for you. And lastly, if you want to learn more about how you can support Hillsboro United Methodist Church or Transformation United Methodist Church financially, please go to www.hilltran.org for more information and to give. We appreciate anything you can do to help. Hey, thanks for being a member of this extended church family. I'm glad we are in this together as kingdom people, commencing shoulder to shoulder to help people rediscover life and experience the kingdom of God.